think that, yes, vending machines should be allowed in schools. But I know for a fact they don't know what kinds of things happen to these kids with vending machines at their schools. Those kids are affected mentally and physically. When we ask the question of, do you think that kids should choose vegetables over candy bar, 95% of the people surveyed agreed with us that kids will not choose vegetables over candy bar. To restate what I've already said,
But can't they get rid of all the unhealthy snacks in the vending machine and only make it healthy?
Are kids going to buy healthy snacks, though, if it's unhealthy? They could, but are they going to spend their money on that? No, thank you. No, thank you. Should we say what I've already said? Vending machines take a lot of money to buy and keep in stock. And what if they get broken down or broken into? With schools restocking their vending machines fairly often, there's always going to be some sort of unhealthy snack waiting there for a helpless kid to take. Lastly, kids will not choose healthy options over non-healthy options in sweets. I mean, let's be real, I know you would take the sweets. And that's why we have won this debate.
Liam, Roy, and Lucas, and my team, Carter and Ryan, for being here to debate. I would also like to thank Mrs. Bennett for putting this debate together. Some people think vending machines should be in schools, but I'm here to tell you why they shouldn't be. There are many problems vending machines can cause. To restate what my group said, schools with vending machines are proven to have more kids that have obesity and diabetes. This is very sad because these two things cause more than 500,000 deaths per year. If vending machines weren't in school, then 10% less kids would have diabetes and obesity. Imagine how many families would be happy to know that this could help stop obesity. That 10% would take off 50,000 deaths per year from the 500,000, which is amazing. This can save a lot of families from being split up. If we can save at least one life, then we should do it. Another problem is that kids who have obesity will keep eating from vending machines. Then they will get picked on and bullied at school. This will cause anxiety because all they can think about is tomorrow when they will get punched and kicked. Also, they might not tell their parents for the fear of the kids getting in trouble. They would get scared because they might think that the kids that got in trouble for bullying would blame the victim and hurt them even more. Bullying will also cause depression. What kid wants to get bullied every day? The kids who are getting bullied don't like it. They probably hate it and want it to stop and have people be nice to them. They are also very sad because they may think they can't do anything about it, but we can do something about it. No vending machines mean less kids with obesity, which is a good thing. Additionally, parents may give their kids money for lunch, but the kids use it for the vending machine. I don't think the parents would be happy to find this out. About 95% of people say that kids wouldn't choose vegetables over candy, which means that they would eat candy but not vegetables in the vending machines. This is proof that kids at a school don't think people would buy vegetables. If kids aren't buying vegetables from vending machines, then the schools won't make money. This means that the school put candy in, and this can cause many problems. The opposing team said that they would limit people to only having one thing a day, but even if they do limit it, kids will still be buying this and it can still cause obesity. And if they limit it down, then people may not buy from the vending machine as often and they may not make as much money. Vending machines might sound like a good thing, but truthfully, they aren't. They can be very bad and cause a lot of problems for the people buying from the vending machines. These problems include obesity, diabetes, and bullying. These problems need to stop but are hard to avoid because kids won't turn down a good candy bar. If they have the opportunity to buy candy, they will, and that's the start of the problem. This problem could be easily fixed if there were no vending machines in schools. No vending machines means no candy, which fixes the problem. We believe vending machines shouldn't be in schools, and we have the good facts and evidence to prove it. And that's why we have won this debate.
should be allowed in school because it is efficient for both students and the school. Vending machines can raise cash so that the school can buy more and better quality supplies or raise the teachers' salaries, which Ms. Bennett would really like. Plastic bottles can also be recycled by the school to make tiny amounts of cash, too. Even if vending machines cost a lot of money, who said you have to buy them? This debate is about if vending machines should be allowed at school. Vending machines are found in schools across the United States. 43% of elementary schools, 74% of middle schools, and 98% of high schools have vending machines. According to Livestrong.com, children who eat a snack in the morning and the afternoon are better able to concentrate in the classroom. This improves comprehension and learning skills. Many people say that vending machines have unhealthy things, but there are also healthy foods like raisins, peanuts, bags of carrots, apple slices, and like 100% juices and pretzels, which are perfect for snacks and or nutrition. Some vending machines have brand new pencils and erasers that you can buy when you forget your writing tools. There are problems that kids bring snacks into the classroom and eat them, but isn't that because teachers don't give us enough time to eat our food? According to NICAP.com, the digestive works better when you eat at random times because if it is on a specific routine of eating at different times randomly will give you occasional stomach aches. And that is why we have one.